Hello, everybody.
Oh, I noticed on my Elgato here, the Twitch is up now on it because on WWE 2K we are running a league, so I have to stream my matches up on Twitch. So I got my stuff set up with them now and YouTube. So maybe if there's any interest, I can do live streaming, but we'll see. But now I got it set up, I can get my channel approved for live streaming, no doubt, so we'll do that. But anyways, I got the game muted. That's the problem I had with the first preseason game. I thought it was muted, and it wasn't, and the video got muted. So I was forced to delete it, but I didn't want to go back. So here we are, week two, so I did win the first game. I think a few might have seen it, but anyways, start weekly training. Preparing for the zone blitz. Bears tend to use it 39% of the time. Shallow cross drill. Alright. This one. Alright. Stop in the draw play. Inside run. Okay. Alright. Yeah, let's focus on Arthur Jones. Alright. Now, let's see here. Anthony, yeah. I don't know why I want to focus on him. Let's see here. Who should we work on? Eddie Royal. Here we go. Alright, start training. Ah, well, darn it. I kind of wanted to just let the computers do that. Oh, well. Get this thing moving. So as the music goes off, I'll turn back the audio back up. Should be a mute button on here, but there isn't. Ah, crap. I don't know if I have my television up or not. Nah. Huh. Not sure what the commentary's picking up, but I already forget what I had the audio on before, darn it. Alright, here we go. Football's a simple game, but you keep making these silly mistakes, we're not gonna win. So alright, I think that should be good. Shallow cross is a progression read concept that features a primary receiver running a shallow crossing route and another receiver running a dig route in the opposite direction. Okay. Alright. Oh, god dang it, they're playing music during this freaking practice. Shut up. God dang it. Oh my god. You know what? I'm quitting this because I don't want to get a copyright. Darn it! This sucks. Man! Yes, quit. Now I gotta mute it again. Darn it! This copyright system of YouTube's is really annoying. I swear, it's extremely annoying. Everything better be the same. Yep, it is. All right. Sim and Sim. There we go. God. Hate that. All right. There we go. Why do I want to sign any of these bad quarterbacks? Yeah, there's nothing good in there anyways. Alright. Start this game up against the Bears. Watch YouTube give me a stupid copyright for that little snippet of audio from that practice. Freaking douchebags. YouTube is douchebags. So bad. God dang, they irritate me. Freaking irritate me. Come on, let's go. Loading time should only take like 5 seconds. Alright, here we go. Get the game audio back up. There you go.
It's hard to imagine this not being a fun game to watch. It's the Bears going up against the Patriots.
Ah, they got Latavius Murray.
Send it out to our guys in the booth. That's Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
Thanks. CA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Gillette Stadium in Foxborough, Mass. Tonight we move on to week 2 of the preseason, and we've got a good matchup here between the Chicago Bears and the New England Patriots. Welcome in, everyone. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. So you've got 1 week of preseason games in the books. Now you start to really assess some of the vets and, of course, some of the young players.
You're exactly right, because now there's a week's worth of film out there for everyone to watch. And for guys who may or may not make these particular teams, that film will
be... All right, here we go.
So maybe they can catch on somewhere else if they have to. But this would be a lot of fun to see how much time the veterans play versus how much time the young guys get.
Whoa. Nice booming kick.
And this will not be...
That is why we got Graham Gano.
...end zone for a touchback.
We'll have a when calling shallow crosses and against inside run. All right. Okay. Let's see here. Now, of course, everyone knows about the cheat. Now, they're going to run the ball. So, it's just blitz.
Now a first carry for Latavius
Murray. There we go.
Fight forward to about the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Really got to fix that glitch.
See if they stay on the ground for second down.
Okay, they're going to throw it. They're doing something else now. They're running the ball now.
They go with Murray again.
Get out of here.
This time it's 3rd and 6. This defense looking for an early stop. This is
all right, let's stop them.
An extra quarter on the field for New England here on 3rd down.
Yeah, another DB on 3rd down. Wilson.
No, you jerks.
First down as they get him to the ground at the 37.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
All right. So this is a run.
A good spot to go with the football.
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
Two Patriots there to bring him down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls.
They're going to run. They're passing.
3 to 4 yards on first down. You're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
On second down, Wilson. And there's a flag on the play. He's going to float this one deep right side.
Whoa. There we go. Who's the flag on? Is it me? Oh, holding. Nice. See, 2nd and 16 or 3rd and 6. Let's go 2nd and 16.
Still 2nd down.
Oh, they're going to run it again. Okay.
Following the penalty, it's Murray. And able to use his blockers to get this up over the 40. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll make it third down.
In today's when you get teams in long yardage situations with your defense, you're really going to go to your speed.
All right.
Smaller, lighter guys on the field in order to cover the expected pass. So they might want to run the ball against a smaller lineup.
Ah, god dang it.
And that's exactly what happened on that play. It was tough on them, and now instead of being in third and very long, they end up setting themselves up in third and manageable. They've got a chance at a first down.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop
darn it!
The field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-arm guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully...
Shut your face.
Still first down. All right, so first down, 5 yards to go.
Still running it. There we go.
Backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Man, it wasn't that long ago that the guy playing that spot was an outside linebacker type of a guy. Now, as a defensive end, how about the speed that he used to get into the backfield and make the play?
Now it's Wilson. And he'll go down inside the 45
before darn it.
Going out of bounds. A gain of 4 on the play, and that's going to bring up a third down.
If you run an out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there?
Toe tap.
You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
They'll run here. It's Murray.
Come on. There we go.
About the 43. He needed 2. He got 1. And that's going to leave him with 4th down of the yard. On now, the 5th-year man, Marquette King, to kick it away. Back deep.
Not even gonna get to see any of my starters play.
And now a low liner. I think he mishit it. No returning this one. It sails out of bounds, and they'll spot it right at the 20.
Just see one long pass by Drew Brees. I don't know if it'll be long to Gronk or not.
They come up in an offset eye. Brees now on first down.
Nice. Alright. Come on, go, go, go. We don't want to lose my starters right away. Come on, hurry up. Come on, go, go, go.
It works for them there. They move the chains.
And we saw them work on it in practice as well. And most teams take a period at a time to work on different things.
Dang it.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, it's the Patriots in possession to begin quarter number 2. But they face a second and long to start.
Now, at least I'm facing the AI. Online, they know I'd be passing it.
And now a first chance for the backup here to throw.
Oh, come on.
Nice catch there.
Throat falls down.
And they were. Let's see, the defense might bring some added pressure as the offense is dealing with a third and long.
All right, let's see here.
What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in.
Ah, man.
Foot dragging.
Little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it. We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes.
I like how they're pushing that catch, and it only got me 3 yards.
That's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
It'll be 37 yards there on the punt, and the Bears take over. The D for the Pats, the Patriots heading back onto the field now. They forced the punt the last time, got off the field. I'm sure some of your D coordinators through the years, you liked when you heard those words, get off the field.
Oh, there's no doubt.
Or maybe
about
you didn't
it.
Like it.
Aw, man.
There goes Duke Johnson. Past the 20.
Touchdown. Oh, my goodness.
Duke Johnson, 69 yards. And the Bears have
darn it.
And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not
wow.
be there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. We focus our attention on the Bears' defense now. They'll be hoping to come up with that same type of effort they had last time when they forced the punt that led to a touchdown.
And that type of effort just continues to carry over, because once you get it done,
God dang it! You feel like you can do
No guarantee, but you gotta like the confidence that they take back out into the field.
Now will they keep that confidence? Time to find out.
Yeah, that wasn't a big run, just a short one there. But guess what? Sometimes you treat it like boxing. You throw that jab out there, and you throw it again, and you throw it again. Then you come with a big punch later. Maybe they're just trying to set him up.
Oh, my God, man. Clemens is terrible quarterback.
Third down here.
God.
After the incomplete pass. They come up in an offset eye.
Oh my God! Gee, I can't do anything here. I hope my freaking backups don't come in. Well, they kind of screwed me out of good backups. Stupid draft won't let me draft more players.
The Bears offense now gets set to head back onto the field. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop this offense?
Well, hopefully there's some determination that sets in, because they weren't ready to go on the last one. Give all the credit.
Oh, what the heck? Oh, get out of here. Screw you. Oh, my God. Screw your face.
With his first career NFL.
What is this?
And the Bears are able to show off their quick strike ability.
What is this? Should I put Drew Brees and Gronk back in here? This is ridiculous.
The Bears send the kicking team out there. And they will not get a chance to return this one, as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now the Patriots gearing up to go now. And still no points on the scoreboard. You're coming off of the three and out. They're just looking for anything to grab onto right now, aren't they?
I'm wondering if someone's going to take charge in the huddle. You know, we always look to the quarterback, but sometimes it's another...
All right. Decent run.
Someone with some excitement and energy is like, all right, guys, let's shake things up and let's go. Because they still have an opportunity to make things happen.
Shake it off.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed, and he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him
blocking.
Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage. Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. And when he can make the play,
God!
That's a big day. It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete.
Oh my God! Terrible, man.
Good news for them now.
This is freaking sucks. Oh my God.
First half here offensively, and then just continued there with that incompletion.
I cannot do anything here.
Heartening for the other guys, those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
Now Rainey. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Here's the Chicago offense coming back out onto the field. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again.
All right. We got to prepare for the run here.
Whether it's on your grease board, right in your playbook, one play drive.
God, the guys can't tackle. Worth crap.
Be careful of is not having a letdown. It was real easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
Yeah, we'll see if it's that easy here. Davis now. Finding time. Going for his running back, and he's got him complete. So a minute 56 to play in this first half. Back to Fox.
Frick. No! I didn't want this. Get out of here.
Seven and an extra defensive back on the field here.
Definitely want to play coverage here.
They'll drop to throw. Ebron with it over the middle. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 6 yards. Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots.
All right. We need a touchdown here bad, and I get it back second half, so I need to try to score.
And now a high kick trying to pin him back. Murphy now to return. They juked him. 12 yards on the return that time. And the Patriots take over.
Alright.
Now they work their way back onto the field. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
Know what I would tell my offense right here?
Short passes for Clemens is about the only way.
I just cut it, alright? So you gotta go out and...
Oh my god, short passes don't work. What the frick?
No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But so, hey, listen, there's gotta be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again.
Oh my god! Jesus, I can't do anything with these freaking backups.
The Bears have put an extra defender in the secondary on third down.
Yep, they're in the nickel. They'll look to throw here.
Come on!
Through the contact. Incomplete.
God!
I'm guessing the call here. It was third and long, so throwing the football was probably the smart play to try and pick it up. But they don't get it, and now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves, gaining some momentum as they force them into a likely punting situation.
Raining out a return. A good return there, call it 13 yards. And it'll be a short field for the Bears as they take over first and 10. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage. Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer. Create space for our runners. And let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And they're able to get this one past the 25. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue. Down, he'll drop to throw it. Ebron caught left side, and down inside the 15 he goes. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Jeez.
Inside the red zone, the offense will operate.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense at every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now.
There. Screw you.
Linebacker. This is going to be the result every time.
Rather have all my players healthy and lose than lose and injure many of my players.
Again, he'll drop to throw.
There we go. Nice.
By the former Super Bowl MVP,
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
They'll run it here. This is Rodgers.
Ah.
8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime.
Now let's go.
Here's Clemens. And quick throw here. That's complete. And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20.
Hurry up, go, go, go. Come on, hurry up, dude.
They'll throw now on the final play. Looking deep here for his tight end, Graham.
Ah. Oops. Ah, I have no highlights anyways.
We're going to skip ahead to quarter number three. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line.
So the Patriots
coming out now. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there because...
Ah...
that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution? Or did they think just they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
We'll find out pretty quickly here if they feel like they had something going.
Nice!
We'll find out. They give them 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
Screen pass was taken away there, but what a nice job improvising, finding other options, and completing the pass anyway.
All right, here we go. Three, nine,
on the ground,
Rodgers.
And very little room to maneuver. He'll get this down to about the 39. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of two, and that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight.
Man, I hate how he freaking goes to the right. I want to go to the left.
4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a third and about four more for first.
It's been a struggle this entire game trying to move the ball on the ground. But every now and then you find a little chink in the armor. And that type of run right there lets them know that they can't stop every single run for almost no game.
Oh, come. Man.
It'll be a pickup of just two, and that'll bring up fourth down. Here's Brad Wing now.
You know what?
As he'll come on for his fifth kick of the night. So the offense took the timeout. Looks like they're ready to go as we get set to resume the action. And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're going to go for it.
Here we go now. Green, 39.
They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. Caught.
Oh, wow, I've seen him go for it in preseason anyways.
Convert and move the sticks. I don't know if I agree with that. I guess they don't care if I agree with that. But, boy, you have to be surprised by that, right?
I definitely was surprised that they decided to go for it in this situation. But they must have either felt like they either had a great play call on, or they're trying to...
Yeah, there we go.
On the pickup, and it gives the Pats a first down. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
He's just going to dump this one off to
there we go.
Out of the backfield. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it'll make it second down. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Now Clemens.
God dang it.
Play number 9 set to come here on the drive on 3rd and 2. They come up in an offset eye. Now they'll run it on the toss.
Oh, come on. Ah, there we go.
Before he's brought down right on the chalk of the 20. Only 3 there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains. And the seemingly endless continues.
Well, partner, they might want to tear up your scouting reports a little bit here because they just broke tendency. Third down, you don't ordinarily see a toss.
Ugh!
Really well and picked up a first down. I love the way the edges were sealed, which allowed him to get to the corner. For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
They'll run. It's Rodgers.
Oh, come on.
Here at about the 11. They got 2 of the 3 they needed there. It leaves them with 3rd and just a yard. So they run it on 2nd down. Now let's see what 3rd down brings here for the offense.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far.
Ah!
Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Now Rodgers.
Yes! Got it.
Touchdown! taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Patriots are back within a score. And they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out, how are we going to slow down this running game? Because on that particular play, they had no answer.
Now it's Duke Johnson.
Go, 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 go,
go. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line.
All right. Need to stop him here. My goodness.
But the door shut fast as he's dropped. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. And this will probably be the last play of the quarter.
All right, let's go.
Foxborough. It's Bears football here. They also have the lead as well as we begin quarter number 4.
Dang it! Stop this guy!
Across the 45 before he's brought down. That one goes for 13 yards and it moves his sticks.
When a coaching staff sees their team run the ball this successfully in the fourth quarter, they're really excited. Because you can plan for a running game all you want and want to press that advantage when you get it. But for the most part, it's a little bit of a surprise. And right now, they've got to keep that going. Want to continue to grind out the clock because definitely in their favor at this stage of the game. Can they close the game out and continue to do exactly what we just saw there, and that's run the football.
The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see...
Try to strip it.
...as they try and bleed it out.
Officially, no gain on the play, and they're left with a 3rd and 8.
Better stop him.
Yeah, great job by the linebacker. Maybe the quarterback, if he could have seen that, could have audible there.
Yeah, he needed to be in a different play because that one just meshed perfectly for the defense.
There we go. Man, I have to have like my best drive in the game here.
Here's Marquette King now as he's on to punt for Chicago. And now a high.
What the frick was that?
Hang it up there.
What the heck was that?
Here on the punt, and the offense will come back onto the field for the 1st and 10. Here comes the Bears defense now back onto the field.
I guess I don't exactly have to try to rush it in right now.
And we don't want to overuse the word
after that sucky punt.
As they head out there for this possession, they need to get the ball back and give their offense a chance to get them totally back into this game.
We'll see if the defense can do just that here. They go play action here on 1st down. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
Looked like they had an opportunity for a big play across the middle, but he didn't have the concentration or the focus necessary and dropped it before he could haul it in.
10 yards still left on 2nd.
Come on.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw.
God, come on, man.
Receiver. And it'll be 3rd and 10 now. Here we go. On 3rd down, he'll drop to throw.
Clements, you freaking bonehead. God!
That was incomplete, but I don't know how much of that falls on the quarterback. He was pressured.
Brandon, the rush...
No, it's all on his fault, stupid idiot.
...to get the ball downfield.
One score down, here we go. They're gonna go for it here on 4th down.
4th down. Well, that definitely says a lot about my backup backup offensive lineman can't freaking block worth crap.
See if they can get something going on this drive. As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play. Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice gain right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this. So the Bears with the football here as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. They stay on the ground on first with Johnson. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain.
Holding offense.
The penalty really backs up the offense here on first down. Now 20 yards to go. Following the penalty, it's Johnson. Oh, look at that.
Oh, look at him turn.
And he'll... Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Johnson on the counter. Fights off another. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. All right, so the timeout over, and all 11 men back out onto the field for the defense. So following the...
Just I shouldn't worry about this loss too much. It's just preseason.
Yardage here, going down back at the 28.
Holding offense.
And some secondary help here for the defense in the nickel on third and long. They'll run it now out of the gun.
Wow.
And he gets this down to the 18. Good enough for a first down. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down.
For so many years, I was convinced it was a myth, you know, because you always hear about the smaller running back, oh, he gets lost, you can't find him, and sometimes that's part of his genius. But it's true. You get behind big offensive linemen, the defensive line guy's trying to...
And he's across for the touchdown, and in the final minute, that should just about seal it.
And that touchdown should make you feel comfortable, but do you really feel like it's totally over yet?
Not totally, but... You're pretty much there.
Yeah, you still got to make sure you stay with it, do all the right things down
the
defense, but that touchdown there, you got to feel good about your chances.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. On the return, here's Marcus Murphy. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. And now out come the Patriots. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they used the term complimentary football?
And I think the ball's out, but this will fortunately wind up out of bounds.
I don't know about you, but I could hear and feel the sigh of relief all the way up here in our booth.
That was palpable. The sideline, the friend there.
No doubt about it. If ball goes on the sideline, retain possession, no turnover. I know his coaches are screaming, just hang on to the ball, man.
And his throw's going to be incomplete. Larry Donnell, the one he was trying to get it to. And it'll be third down. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable. Usually an excellent target.
Dude, no one can catch the ball at all.
Today's NFL, these...
God, I'm glad I don't have these idiots starting for my team. God.
were just unable to complete the pass.
Terrible.
All right, here we go.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Wide open receiver complete. And he takes this one all the way across midfield into enemy territory down to the 40-yard line. And now they're in the hurry-up. Here's Clemens. He's going to let it fly. And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here.
But it's not been the best game for him, but he definitely tried to get by.
Yeah, Clemens is terrible. I really wish this game would have allowed me to select my player.
Just trying to get going.
Freaking awful, man.
And continue to fire.
Second down here after the incomplete pass.
Here we go.
Back to throw again. And that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left.
Normally he's pretty reliable. Usually catches what's thrown to him. On that play, he simply dropped it.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. So a 3rd and 10, and defensively, a dime look, 6 DBs. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And this is...
Oh, wow.
It's a late touchdown, but maybe too late. Still a little time left on the clock, however. And he's a little bit on the shorter side as a receiver. Maybe sometimes for the defense...
Oh, no! I can't see!
Lost in the traffic.
Oh wow, I lucked out there.
Just winning with height or even speed. They used
to... Stupid game clip recorded popped up.
Wide, skinny, whatever. There it results in a touchdown. So with just a few ticks left, they need a miracle. And this is going to be taken in.
Ah.
It appears they're going to win this game. They had to go for it with no timeouts remaining.
Darn it.
Now this one's as good as over.
They gave it an effort. They tried their best, did everything they could to try and get the ball on the onside kick. You're exactly right. They had to try it. It was their only option. And now this game is done. Just take it, kneel, and call it a day.
The win for the Bears.
I couldn't get anything going with those backups at all. Freaking pathetic, man. God, Clemens, ugh. That's awful game. Awful.